اوكي، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. إن شاء الله today we will start with the first chapter. Okay, so I'm uploading this video in hopes that you can view it later on, and if needed, you can see over and over again. We are just going to do a very short chapter introduction. This is chapter 1.1, which is understanding operating system. So basic idea of an operating system. So you need to understand what is an operating system for this course, and we will try to define an operating system and also an application system, or sometimes it's said as an application software. So on your screen now, I'm showing examples of operating system. So, among which I think you are always all familiar with Windows operating system, and some of you maybe are familiar with Red Hat operating system, Linux operating system, OX, and these are some other examples. So basically, what is an operating system? An operating system is the system that runs a personal computer or a PC. Or your maybe and now your handphone. So that is a basic idea of what an operating system is. So what does an operating system do? It performs basic tasks. The example is recognizing your inputs. What is your input to the personal computer or your phone? So it recognizes any input, whether it's coming from a keyboard or mouse, or maybe you are texting something. You're doing your texting something, or you're getting information in your PC or your handphone. So that is what an operating system does. It recognizes what input comes in, and it also sends out the output. Okay, the output can be to the monitor, can be in terms of a picture, what you are seeing now, or can be in terms of sound. So that is also an output, and it also keep track with all your files directly on your hard disk. Okay, so an operating system keeps track of all this. So a directory and a folder is almost a similar thing, but in the older days we used the term called directory, but now we use the term called files. Oh, sorry, folder. So basic idea is an operating system will keep track of which file is in which folder is in which directory, or so on and so forth. Okay, and then it also controls certain devices, such as it controls the driver, the disk driver, or printer, the mouse, the hard disk, and so on and so forth. So, the term operating system is the most important program that runs on a computer. Without the operating system, the computer would not run. Okay, would not be, cannot be operated. Okay, so an operating system is an interface between the computer and the user. Okay, so how does, let me give you an example of an operating system or an idea. Suppose you want to switch on the fan. Okay, switch on the fan. Here, keep us, eh? All right, so what do you do? You go to the switch button and you press the button, and something happens and the fan switched on. Without the switch, you are unable to switch on the fan. So you as the user, the switch is the operating system and the fan is the hardware. Okay, so without switching on the switch, you are unable to rotate the fan. Yes, some people might say without switch we can also switch on the fan. You know, we can just put in the wires and so on. And voila, you can run. Yes, you can do that, but that is more tedious. However, if you have a switch there, you just press the button and you say you want to go to speed number 4, automatically the fan will go to speed number 4. So the operating system, you can assume it's like a small switch. Okay, it is responsible for switching on the fan. So that's why we got to point number 3 here, responsible for management and coordination of activities and the sharing of resources. So what does it mean by coordinate? So that means it coordinates which program are you opening, which program are you using, which software are you opening, which file are you downloading, which file are you uploading, which file are you sharing. So this is a responsibility of an operating system. And which resources are you sharing? For example, you are in a computer lab, all of you are connected to one printer, so the operating system will coordinate which file will go first and print and so on and so on. So it coordinates the sharing. Okay, so this is how a computer system looks like. The user, you and me, we go through an application, goes through the operating system, and it comes in, uses the hardware. Okay, so a user like me and you, we are the users. We use an application. Say the application that we use is Microsoft Word. Okay, so we are using Microsoft Word. Okay, so you open Microsoft Word and then you use Microsoft Word. But in order for you to use Microsoft Word, you need to access certain files. So this is the job of the operating system. And then when the user types in certain information, that information needs to come out in the monitor. So the operating system will do that. Okay, so the, when it comes up to the monitor, that's where you have the hardware access. Okay, so you have the user here, you have the application here, you have the operating system here, and you have the hardware. So all of these are connected. Let's say you do not have an operating system. You have the user, you have the program, but or the application software, but how are you going to connect to the hardware? So that is how it works. Let me give you another example. My phone. This is also considered hardware. It is built in with an operating system inside it, Android. So Android is also another type of operating system. So I have a few things here. Let's say, for example, I want to access. Let's say I want to access my phone book, my contact list. Okay, so that is an application. Okay, application. So I want to access my. Okay, is my. Okay, here we go. This is my contact list. Okay, and see the contact list. So these are my contact list. So this is an application software. Using an application software, and it connects to the operating system, and when it connects to operating system, it reappears in this hardware. Okay. Okay. So these are the types of devices that are sometimes connected to the operating system. We have the disk drive, mouse, printer, keyboard, and application software. Okay. There are different types of application software. You have Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, PowerPoint. Application software and operating systems are two different things. Application software is a dedicated software for a certain type of application. If you want to use Excel, it's only meant for calculation. If you want to use Microsoft Word, it's meant for typing of documents. So application software has a specific task. Unlike an operating system controls everything. It's more of a general task. Okay, so you always remember two things. What is the difference between operating system and application software? These are two different main differences. Okay, these are two different things, and you need to understand what is the difference between operating system and application software. Let me just go back and see. An operating system is the most important thing, and point number three, management and coordination activities and the time and the sharing of resources. Okay, so you have three points here. What is the operating system? It is supposed to manage, coordinate, and share. So remember these three points. So when I ask you in your test or quiz, what is an operating system? Remember these three points: manage, coordinate, and also share. Okay, so a little bit history of operating system. So we started with the first generation in 1945. You have vacuum tubes. Well, those times you don't have flat screen, you have vacuum tubes. You have seen those screens which are which are those big TVs behind it. Okay, let me stop for